Namaste viewers, welcome back to Gnana Degula channel. Wish you all a very happy and then prosperous Navaratri. During this period, the Ma Parvati is worshipped in various forms. She appears in various forms. She, the manifestation of Ma Durga, the manifestation of the Shakti, the feminine power, in various forms. All these stories come in Devi Bhagavata. So we will go through a few stories, some of the stories of her incarnation, of her appearance in this world to eradicate, to remove troubles, problems which arise. Time and again, you know, some or the other problems, you know, arise, and then Ma Parvati takes on the form of a severe soldier, and then she destroys the evils. So before we go to the actual story of this particular incident, we request you to please like, share, and then subscribe to our channel. Now, to begin the story, long time ago, Parvati was a very powerful goddess and very devoutful, lot of Shakti, you know, embodiment of Shakti. She married Lord Shiva. She was married to Lord Shiva. But he had become very sad and quiet after his wife, not exactly first wife, after the wife committed Sati, she had left the world. In one of the incidences where her father, Parvati's father, Daksha, you know, he performs a yajna called as Daksha yajna, great yajna, wherein he invites everybody but not his daughter and son-in-law. No, daughter, out of affection, out of love towards her father, despite not being invited, she goes to the father Brahma, where she is performing this great yajna called as Daksha yajna. There the father humiliates Shiva, insults Shiva, thereby the Parvati, wife of Shiva, is enraged. She gets very angry, and then she jumps into the ritualistic fire, yajna, the yajna mantapa, where all these offerings were being given, this fire act, sacrificial fire. She jumps and then ends her life. This incidence of the wife, the Sati of Shiva, ending her life, makes Shiva very sad, and he is very quiet. He spent all his time in deep meditation, and uh, away from everyone, secluded. No one can go to him. Like that he was just there. He is performing his penance there, severe penance. In the meantime, two terrible rakshasas, demons, Surahpadman and then Tarakasura, these two demons, you know, they were always causing trouble everywhere. Wherever they go, they were causing trouble. They were causing trouble in Bhuloka, Devaloka, all lokas, you know, they were going, they were able to go everywhere and then they were troubling. They had become so strong, very strong, that nobody could defeat them. Even gods also couldn't defeat them. The gods were worried because they were on constantly being troubled by these two demons, Tarakasura and Surahpadman. They went to their lords and their masters of the lords, Sri Mahavishnu, and then they sought his help. So, Lord Vishnu, you know, he sees from his yoga maya, he understands, and then he reminds them that nobody can shake them, nobody can kill them, nobody can destroy them, except the child of Shiva and Parvati. Only a child, only a son born to these Shiva and Parvati could defeat these demons. But now Shiva had become so distant and so he was totally in penance. And he, now Sati is also not there. He wasn't thinking about having a child at all. He was just only doing penance. So the gods, everybody were worried. They sought the help of Narada. Narada was able to move around in all lokas. And then at that moment, this wise sage Narada, when they sought his help, you know, Narada said, I will do something. And then Narada visited Parvati and told her she was the rebirth of Sati. Rebirth of Sati, who had committed, who had jumped into the sacrificial fire. He said she was the rebirth of Sati and that she could marry Shiva again if she did great penance. Parvati also loved Shiva and wanted to be with him. So she decided to perform a very great, difficult tapasya, penance, to win his heart. She gave up all comforts and focused on her meditation for hundreds and thousands of years. After a long time, Shiva was impressed by her devotion and agreed to marry her. Here also there are some stories, you know, wherein the Cupid, the god, the Manmatha, god of love, you know, Cupid, fires a love arrow at Shiva, who is doing penance, and the Shiva opens his eyes, and then immediately he was so enraged, he burnt Manmatha. It is called as Kamadahana. Some stories tell about this incidents also. Anyway, so Shiva was impressed by her devotion and agreed to marry her. When Parvati and Shiva got married, Parvati was also a very beautiful girl. Something magic, magical happened. They were in love and Shiva could not control his affection, love towards Parvati. A brilliant seed of energy was created from their love. This seed, this bija was so powerful. It was very, like, you know, powerful that no one could hold it. Lord Agni, the god of fire, also could not hold it because it would, the intense of these, this particular seed was so, heat was so hot that he could not handle its, heat. Even though he was a god of heat, fire. He tried to carry it, but he couldn't handle it. So the sacred river Ganga took the seed to keep it safe. Now, one more twist to this story is that Parvati also transformed herself into water to protect the seed. Soon from this seed, a beautiful baby was born. He was named as Kartikeya and he had six faces, six lovely mothers known as Krittikas. Six lovely mothers known as Krittikas, six faces of Kartikeya, that is Subramanya, Shanmukha, with six faces. Krittikas took care of him and that's how he got the name Kartikeya. He grew up to be a very brave warrior who would one day defeat the demons and bring peace to the world. So he fought against those demons, Tarakasura and one more, his Surahpadman and Tarakasura. He killed both of them. To the world, it was a great, benefit to the world. They were all being troubled. The world was being troubled by these Rakshasas and it came to an end. So, this is the story of Ma Skandamata. Skanda means Shanmukha, Vadivel, Muruga. He is called by several names. This Skandamata, he is an incarnation of Parvati who gave birth to this Kartikeya. And she is the loving mother of Kartikeya. This teaches us the power of devotion, love and bravery. This is quite an interesting story. Viewers, with this story we will conclude our one of the stories of Ma Parvati. I hope this is quite interesting. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you. All the best for your Dasara festivals. Thank you.